Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I've got some brand new lipsticks for us to play with. This is a line created by Poppy King. She is also the creator behind Lipstick Queen. She has since left that company or sold that company and has started this brand new lipstick company. It's called Femme de Poppy, and they're starting with three new lipstick shades. So they're being sold exclusively at Barney's. I purchased these off of barneys.com, and they are $48 each. So I was on the Barney's website when I purchased these, and they have like a blog post talking about Poppy's inspiration behind not only the formulas and the colors, but the packaging and all of that. So let me just show you the packaging really quickly. All of the lipsticks come in this box and sleeve. And so this is just an outer sleeve. And so the box comes out and all the lipsticks come inside this box. And then here is the lipstick case. We have the F de P, the Femme de Poppy logo there. And I just love this font. It's so Art Nouveau. It's so like turn of the century. And I just absolutely love, well, turn of the 20th century. And I just love the like the feels that it gives me. This lipstick case is very standard. It's plastic. It, you know, clicks shut. It's not magnetic. And it just twists up. We have gold finish here and then the red F to P on the inside. There's no crazy special treatment to the actual bullets of the lipsticks. And I just love these. And they have a nice weight to them. They don't feel inexpensive or cheap in any way. They actually feel, they feel really nice in the hands. So when I was reading the description of these lipsticks, they're supposed to be like a sheer, buildable, matte kind of formula. And I thought, wow, that is like such an interesting mix of characteristics for a lipstick. Usually for me, if something is sheer, it's not really buildable. It ends up being very creamy or very glossy. And matte lipsticks, they're generally very highly pigmented and, you know, also generally very buildable. So kind of like the mashing of the two, this like sheer, buildable, matte situation, I was just, my curiosity was really piqued. And you guys know, or you may not know, but I'm not always the biggest fan of matte lipsticks. So I thought, well, if it's kind of sheer, then maybe it's not going to be too drying. And it is supposed to have like a creamy moisturizing feel to them. And the other thing I thought was interesting and fun, and I remember seeing this maybe a couple of times in the Lipstick Queen line, but these are lip products that are supposed to kind of react to the wearer's heat, I guess, and supposed to change or shift the color a little bit. So again, I was really intrigued, and usually when I have played with like color shifting products, they usually kind of start out kind of sheer, and then what happens is the color will kind of like develop with the heat of your skin, and I always kind of end up with the same kind of like purpley mauve kind of color. So the fact that these are already colored, these are already pigmented, and that they shift from there, again, I was really intrigued. So I personally have never played with a lipstick that is sheer, buildable, matte, and is supposed to like color shift. So when these arrived on my doorstep, I was like, hand them over. I need to put them on right now. And they're all a lot of fun. So let's talk about each color. And what I'll do is just flash footage of me holding up the lipstick, doing a close-up, giving you a hand swatch, and also giving you some lip swatches. For my lip swatches, I'll show you me applying it. And then what I'll do is I'll cut and go to the very end because I let them sit for a while so you could see for yourself whether or not they shifted. The shift is very, very minor, I wanna say. But let's go ahead and talk about each color. So I'm gonna start with the nude color, which is called Emperor's Nude, which I think is the most clever, clever name. I just love it. This is just a really beautiful peach color, again, in the bullet. And it has just the finest, finest hint of like a gold sparkle in there. It's very, very, like very, very micro gold. All it will do is just kind of give your lips a little bit of a sheen. But true to the description, these go on fairly sheer and they are buildable. So if you kind of just go back and forth with the bullet, you'll definitely get a more opaque coverage. The other thing I noticed is while these aren't the slipperiest formula, you know, so many lipsticks today are so slick, you know, they're so slippery. They just kind of slide and glide right onto your lips. These lipsticks don't have that. These lipsticks feel a little bit more like old school. These lipsticks feel a little bit more like lipsticks from like the first lipsticks I ever played with, like from the 80s. They just feel really waxy. That's the word I'm looking for. They just feel really, really waxy. So they do glide on, but they don't have that like crazy, like whoop, like slip right onto your lips. And it was, it's just different, you know? I don't want to say that one is better than the other, but it's just different. But what I noticed, and I'm hoping that my footage showed you a little bit, because it's a little bit hard to capture such a small nuance between the colors. But when I first put it on, it definitely looked true to what you see in the bullet. It was very peach, very nude. But I think the longer it sat on my lips, it turned just a little bit pink, a little bit less orange. So I didn't necessarily mind that. But these do definitely shift a little bit. And when it comes to a nude, I know sometimes colors can shift from something that you find wearable to something that looks kind of gross on your lips. So I thought that was really interesting to do that with a nude lipstick. And I really like how the color turned out. So the next color is Lip and Rose. And actually, I am looking at the label at the bottom here. So all of these lipsticks were made in Canada, and they all have an 18-month shelf life. Sorry, back to Lip and Rose. So this color is just a really beautiful pink color. I think this pink is just really pretty, and I don't think that this color itself is especially extraordinary, but I don't feel like I see this exact tone of pink really ever. I feel like they're either peachier or they're even a little bit cooler. This seems like really kind of neutral. So I was very curious how this was going to sit on my lips, how the color would shift a little bit. So this one has like no shimmer to it whatsoever. And this color, I don't think I really noticed a shift. You guys will let me know in the comments section. Again, I'll do like my lip swatch and I'll have like the cut of the very end. You let me know if you see a shift, but I didn't really see one. And I know these are supposed to be a matte, and while I don't find them especially shiny, there's definitely no gloss to them. They're not especially like creamy feeling even on the lips. I don't find them to be like a flat, flat matte. I find them to be really, really wearable. I don't think that they make my lips look dry. They don't make my lips feel dry. So if you're like a matte lover, like you love that flat matte look, I don't think that these are for you. They're definitely a little bit different from that. And then the last one is the color that I actually have on, and this is called Eve. And I was super excited for this color. So this is the darkest of the three. And this one actually has a little bit of like a kind of burnt brown, deep brown color to it. But I don't know, it's one of those colors that looks a little bit different depending on what light you're in. Sometimes it looks a little bit brown, sometimes it looks a little bit more red. It's just incredibly beautiful. This also has some gold shimmer in it, like the Emperor's Nude, but the gold shimmer in this is much more pronounced. I wanna say the glittery bits are a little bit bigger than they are in the Emperor's Nude. They're not big at all, it's not chunky. I don't feel them in any way, but in Emperor's Nude, they're so fine that in here, they're just a little bit more obvious. So this color also, I felt like when I put it on, it looked very, very warm. And then as it reacted to my heat, I feel like it cooled a little bit, like it turned a little bit pink. And again, let me know down below in the comment section if you see it. I don't know, maybe I was just staring at these colors a lot, but I feel like that's what I saw in terms of this color at least. So I wore the Lip and Rose color for like half of the day yesterday. The longevity is nice. Like if you don't drink and you don't eat, it will stay put. It's not like a lighter lip product that just kind of disappears slowly, like you just slowly start to ingest it. It's not like that. It will definitely stay put on your lips. And then through a meal and through drinking, it definitely starts to fade a little bit. So these are not like long lasting lipsticks in any way, but I have to say there's something very different about this lipstick formula. And I just don't know if everyone's gonna like it. I mean, I feel like I'm still trying to decide if I like it, but they definitely feel like a throwback. They feel like a basic lipstick. I just feel like they're kind of old school. And now in the year 2019, it's kind of like new again. They just remind me of my mom and like the 70s in almost every way, in the packaging, in the feel, in the actual formula, in the colors that she picked. Like this rose color is, I feel like the color probably every woman wore when we kind of entered the workforce. Like I feel like this is the color you picked. It was like your lips, but prettier. I don't know. You guys sound off in the comment section, but I just find this line to be like really inspired. I just feel like this has been the most provocative release so far between the colors that she picked, the formula, the packaging, the artistry, like everything about it is so, I don't know. It's like, it's mysterious and nostalgic all at the same time. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Please, again, sound off in the comment section. Let me know what you guys think about the packaging and the colors and this formula, all that stuff. I would love to hear from you, and subscribe if you haven't already. I'll see you in my next video.